Students, the chapter factorization. Now today in this video we'll study about the factorization of the algebraic expression using identities. And if you remember, then we have read about the three identities as a plus b whole square is equals to a square plus 2ab plus b square. A plus b whole square is equals to a square plus 2ab plus b square. Now this is written in the form of a plus b into a plus b, and this is the product form. So when product form is given, we can factorize them as a plus b whole square, as in this form. So this is the product given and these are the factors. Next identity of a minus b whole square, which is given as a square minus 2ab plus b square, which in turn can be written in the form a minus b into a minus b. A square minus 2ab plus b square is equals to a minus b into a minus b. So this is the factor form and this is the product form. This expression can be factorized into this one. Now you can see that there are three terms. Three terms are there. So it is a trinomial. Trinomial can be expressed as the product of the binomials. And the third identity as a square minus b square is equals to a plus b into a minus b. This is the product form and these are the factors. Now you can see that this a square and b square both are the perfect square terms. So when the perfect square terms are given, we can write in terms of the product as a plus b into a minus b. Now let us try to solve some questions of the exercise 14.2. Now here is the trinomial given for exercise 14.2. The first question you have to factorize. Trinomial is given a square plus 8a plus 16. Now if you remember, then we know that 16 is a square of 4 and a is a square of a square. So two of the term, they are the perfect square term. And the third one is the having this variable and the constant. So we can use this in terms of the identity as a square plus 2ab plus b square, where two terms, they are the perfect square terms. These two terms, they are the perfect square terms. So this term and this term is the perfect square term, and 2ab, it can be in place of the 8a. So let us write a square as the square of a and 16 as the square of 4. Now you can see that we are having the first term as a and the second term as 4. Now the midterm we write as the product of 2 into first term into the second term as 2 into a into 4. Now 2, 4 j is 8, 8a. So 8a we have written as in this form. Now this is a plus b whole square. This is the expansion of a plus b whole square. So you can write this as a plus 4 whole square. Next is p square minus 10p plus 25. Again we can see that this is the p square term, square of p, and 25 is a square of 5. Now the middle term we have to write in terms of the product. Here is minus sign, so minus sign will be there. Now we'll write them in the square form. Now the first term is p and the second term is 5. Here minus 5 is there. So if you write it as minus 5 square, as in this form, minus 5 square, then the middle term can be written as the product of the first term and the second term, as 2 into p into minus 5, and because of that minus sign, this minus sign will be there. So we can write this as this minus sign is here. So 2 into 5 is 10, so it is 10p. We have written this in the form of p minus 5 whole square. This is the expansion of p minus 5 whole square. Now here in this expression, what we see is that 4x square, this is the square of 2x and 4 is a square of 2. So writing these two in terms of the square terms as in this form. Now this 8x is the splitting of these terms. Now let us write this 8x in terms of the product as written as 2 into 2x into 2. 2 into 2 is 4, 4 into 2 is 8x. So 8x we have written in this form. Now this is the square of 2x minus 2. 2x minus 2 whole square. So you have seen that in these three examples, we have just a plus b whole square used in the first question as a plus 4 whole square. In the second one, we are having p minus 5 using the identity of a minus b whole square. And in the third one also, we are having a minus b whole square. Now we'll see the sum of the questions of the third identity of a square minus b square. Now see this second question. 4p square minus 9q square. If you see carefully, then 4p is the square of 2p and 9q is the square of 3q. So we can write this in the form of a square as 2p square minus 3q square. Now splitting this in the form of a plus b into a minus b, where the first term is 2p and the second term is 3q, as in this form 2p plus 3q and 2p minus 3q. Now see this question. 16x to the power 5 minus 144x cube. Now we know that 16 is a square of 4 and 144 is a square of 12, but x to the power 5 and x to the power 3, they are not the perfect square terms, but they can be taken common from these two, as x to the power 3 is common in both. The lower power is common in both. So we just take out x to the power 3 as common. Left is 16x square minus 144. Now here 16x square is a square of 4x and 144 is a square of 12. If you remember, then 144 is a multiple of 16 also, but you can just solve in this way that 16 is a square of 4. 4x square minus 12 square. Now this is in the form of a square minus b square, and now it can be written in the form of as a plus b into a minus b. So now you can see that we have written in this form as 4x minus 12 and 4x plus 12 in the form of expansion of a plus b into a minus b.